Red hugged me, and Gail reached for Roxy. And we cried.
No other nurse I'd rather die beside, I said.
They flew right over us, a second chance at life. And I fell to my knees, not able to breathe, clawing at my chest and neck. Red lifted me by the scruff of my neck, and we bolted down the street into the trees, where I took a moment to try and catch my breath. Nobody had followed us. And if they'd seen us from their loft windows, we couldn't tell. We watched the bombers fly off over the treetops, heading east.
Let's go,
Red said. And she tried to make us leave right away.
Wait a minute, will ya?
Roxy said, bracing her knees, breathing heavily from the run.
We don't have a minute,
Red said. And we walked while still trying to catch our breath. A mile, at least, until the forest gave way to a field of brown grass infested with giant grasshoppers. Gail's hands flew to her face.
They're everywhere!
They clung to our arms and legs, hopped under our skirts, and tangled with our hair. The steps we took to outrun them only seemed to aggravate the situation, making every step worse.
Relax,
Red said. But she was addressing Gail mostly, who yelped and hopped with each grasshopper that landed on her.
There's nothing we can do but walk our way out. And stay close. If you pay more attention to the grasshoppers, you'll stray off.
Red's gaze rolled over the field.
There could be mines out here.
I reached for Gail's hand.
Come on,
I said, leading her, and we walked together through the field. The grasses turned marshy in places from the recent rain, looking a little moldy and smelling foul. One step was firm and solid, then the other, squishy and slippery with just enough grass to keep the mud from caking to our shoes.